Hello, sir. This is Jayant from NCN Magazine.
Okay.
So we just introduced GECR to our audiences because we really want to know about what all things you are doing in India and what are initiatives you are taking in this sector.
Okay. First of all, maybe I just give you a little bit of my backgrounds. I used to offer D-Link as a worldwide CEO. You may know D-Link is a listed company in India, right? So a few years back, we brought up D-Link and become more than 100 million company. And in that time, we are doing the networking. So the networking is connected to the different device. And we see, okay, the networking actually is a service. Okay, because you need to connect to customer, to connect to the channel partner. Then when channel partner sell to the service, you have to be back up the channel partner to do the support, service, training, all different kind of things. So instead of just sell a box, okay, you need to sell the full entire solution and service. And I set up this global channel resources to come from the idea when I work in D-Link, I see, okay, actually the channel partner really need a end-to-end solutions, okay, in particular is the system and the service, right? So I see the IoT is coming, Internet of the Things is coming, the cloud computing is coming, so the worldwide is many new, okay, IoT vendors coming from different part of the world, especially in India, okay, and actually according to the statistic, the report, 43% of the IoT solution come from India. So actually, if you want to find the IoT solution, you just come here, and just lucky, because I've been in India for so many years, we were so successful, I have a very good team. So in terms of IoT, you need to do things, okay, you need to do really local touch, localized, you need to do the local service. Okay, you also connect to the network connect to the different device. And now the device is more powerful with the sensor, with the camera, but the other side was the cloud computing and also the application, and actually is the more important to drive the whole IoT solutions. So doing that, okay, I think about, okay, 20 years ago I do networking and very successful in terms of localized support service and get the customer through the channel partner, and the channel partner are happy with all this kind of ecosystem reform. And so what's the difference today, okay, as the IoT as per se? Okay, the sensor is still there, or the networking and everything is still there. The difference is, okay, you need to provide more application and more data and more support. So you need the system. So a few years back, I think, okay, this is a golden opportunity. So why not why we just build a system? Okay, what kind of system? The GCR build is a kind of a cross-border e-commerce, okay, to help the channel partner to see our solution. Okay, so we can find the solution from worldwide because IoT, the solution is coming from everywhere, the UK, US, and particularly 43% in India, right? So when you see the solution, then channel partner can buy the solution, can install the solution, and can do all the implementation, the solution to their customer, right? So this is really changed the whole industrial shape, because in the past, we just develop the solutions, okay? Then we want to sell it, sell to channel partner, the channel partner sell to customer. But actually the IoT coming, okay, there are so many vendors, right? So you don't need to actually develop your own solution, you just find the vendor solutions and you put into our platform, which is e-commerce platform, right? Then plus we also have, because IoT is the software, hardware together. So you also need to have a software distribution platform, a service platform. So we have these two platforms together, catering for Smart Connect for the IoT. Then we deploy it to the worldwide. So for example, like a solution from the India, then probably we help the India solution provider and go to Brazil, go to Southeast Asia, and to do the landing. So in that side, we also have a team, okay, and to help the channel partner, okay, to understand the solution, to do the training, and also to help the channel partner to do the implementation. In the same time, the solution from US, we do the same thing in India. So what's the IoT point? Okay, IoT point is you provide a kind of a solution which is must increase the end user's revenue, or must increase the end user's productivity, or reduce their expense, right? So if IoT don't have this value, then nobody will use IoT, right? So when users see the value, but they don't know how to do it, then we help the channel partner to do it. Okay, so we act as the channel partners, the resources. Mm-hmm. Okay, but so GCR, okay, in the past few years, we developed a system for the e-commerce, we developed a system for the cloud service delivery. We also have a channel community system, right? So for the system, it looks like, okay, Uber, you know the Uber? Or here is a Grab, right? Okay, it's an internet company. So we are the internet plus company. Okay, we want to plus for example, like a channel partner with many like system integrator, value added reseller, ISP, or even the consultant or marketing agent, this kind of channel partner. Then we use our online and we find a lot of solution from the worldwide, and we plus the local resource, which is the channel partner. They do the local implementation. Then we complete the whole value chains and help the This worldwide solution partner can be localized and can and end user can enjoy this new IoT benefit. That's the what we are doing.
Okay. Yeah. So you have seen a way of change,
yeah.
Wave of change in India market also.
Yes.
So the obviously with the devices there is a constant need of solutions.
Yes.
Where I think GCR is playing a vital role to cater this kind of segment, right?
Yes.
So, how you feel like there is a gap? When do you feel that there is some kind of gap where these kind of problems the SI and the channel partners are facing?
Mm-hmm.
What kind of problem you see?
Actually, in the past, okay, when you deal with the solution, right? SI normally they have to find the solution by themselves. But if the solution not complete, they don't have to develop a solution by themselves. They have to go to the customer, particularly for the business customer, enterprise customer. Then they have to go to survey one by one different department and got the spec. Then they start to develop, right? Maybe some solution they also get from outside, but integrate to then become a system integrator, right? So become very project based. With this cost of maybe 2 years, 3 years, and very costly. Okay, but in this now, because there are so many vendors, they are doing different kind of perspective, like smart retail, then you have people see like how to people walking to your shops, right? Then connect to your POS, connect to your CRM, or connect to your ERP, all this kind of thing. And you do the facial recognition, you do the heat map, you do the what kind of people go to buy, right? This is just a very typical example of the smart retail and smart education, different things. So different kind of vertical in the past, okay, SI have to sourcing the solution by themselves. Then they have to localize the solution by themselves. Okay, then they have to implement the solution. Okay, then they sometimes need to, because they need to collect the money, right? Mm-hmm. So now we are thinking, okay, for the benefit of the SI, increase their productivity, we sourcing the solution for them. Mm-hmm. We put the solution together as a different vertical. Mm-hmm. Then they can just go to our website, they see the solution and they buy the solution. Okay, then online buy the solution and they go to implement. Mm-hmm. So they don't need to worry about how to deal with those vendors. Mm-hmm. They don't need to worry about how to support, okay, this, because we are behind them, we are back up them, okay, in terms of when you stay at cross-border trading, right? We have a logistic, we have a payment, okay, we also work with the e-payment company, different kind of e-payment facility and logistic company, right? And also call center company. So actually, as I say, we are the internet plus company. So we plus different resource, mm-hmm. okay, to complete the whole value chain. Yeah. So SI just go to website, see, then register and start to work with us. And our local people also can help us, help them to deploy all the things. Yeah.
So in which sectors you are
seeing this kind of growth? Yeah, as I mentioned, okay, we start with from the smart retail, okay. Then we have a smart education, okay, and then have a smart hospitality. Then also a very important one is, as I say, the work with the media agent or something. It's a new way of the digitalized. So that means a lot of this the media company, okay, they need a digital marketing type of tool. Mm-hmm. And we have a lot of this kind of digital marketing solution for them. For example, like a signage, for example, like interactive broadcasting or something. Yeah, so that's all this the new way of the doing.
So how different are you from the e-commerce platform that are playing over here?
Okay. Yeah, actually, as I say, okay, because we are this kind of end-to-end provider. Okay, so e-commerce is just one of our tools, okay, to make all this more efficient and more productive. For example, like people can see each other, like Alibaba, right? Mm-hmm. So they can meet each other. But other than that, then we also facilitate like payment, logistics, and service. So we are the end-to-end complete. So the channel partner just go to our website and talk to our people, then they get the whole things. And yeah, other than the e-commerce, they just maybe just go to a website, buy more consumer type of a product and the implement. We are more commercial. We are in the business sector. Okay, so we are in more B2B. And so the vendor to us, and we to the channel partner. But channel partner to B, to their commercial customer. Yeah.
So where is your head office?
Okay, our headquarters in Singapore. Okay, but our major development in the past 3 years are in Taiwan. Mm-hmm. But now we come to India since last September. Okay, we start a small team and now grow like a team is 12, 13 people.
Where is that India office?
India office is in Bombay, okay. But we do have people here. Mm-hmm. And also we have people in Bangalore. Okay. And we are expanding. So now Bombay is like a commercial office. We have a PM there, okay, to recruit a lot of independent solution provider. And also, we also have the service center in Bombay. And the graduate will expand to different regions.
Okay, yeah. So obviously the demand will increase and...
Yeah, because the scenario is, okay, for the IoT, you have to localize.
Yeah.
You have to provide a local service. So this is just a start. Eventually, we are going to have a lot of offices in all over the India. Okay. Yeah.
So what is the strength of India team? So how many people are...
12 people, okay. Yeah. Then actually, we have very senior people. Mm-hmm. So we have D-Link, senior VP joined me, it's my lucky. Mm-hmm. Okay, and also Gigabyte's senior VP joined me. And also we have very senior like PM, mm-hmm. okay, and the marketing people, mm-hmm. and also the finance people. So now we have a small team, but it's a full functions already. And we'll expand the R&D and more sales in different territory.
So going forward, what is your India plan, basically? Just want to know, in next couple of years, where you want to,
Actually, we, GCR. Yeah, because we see India as a different, because even we are the headquarters in Singapore, but I think that my personal, because I have been in India for so many years, and also we grew India, dealing India. And in this new IoT times, okay, because India is an English-speaking country, so if you develop a solution, you can sell to worldwide. Okay, India is very rich in software. Okay, and IoT is software oriented; it's not hardware oriented. So we should have a lot of solution coming from India. Then also, in India, a lot of talents are good in the marketing. And also good in the platform enhancement. So our platform come here to can find a solution, can find a channel, because we already have a lot of channel partner. Then working, then we can really exercise that this platform become the robustic. Then you can just copy all these models to Indonesia, to Thailand, to different world. So in this moment, actually India is my most important, and actually it's like my home market, because as a platform company, you really need have a home market. It's like Amazon have a US, Alibaba have China, right? But in Taiwan or Singapore is too small, so we need to find a very rich market with a rich talent and with rich potential. Yeah. So In summary, actually, GCR is a platform. We see a huge opportunity coming from the IoT, different kind of solutions. So one side, we talk about the ISV, okay, the solution provider. We have a huge channel base and open to them, okay. So they can come to us, then we help them and to go to the worldwide or India. Okay, the other side, we create an ecosystem for the channel partner. So channel partner up to now today, because of all these buy and sell, all these things are getting less values. So we provide a resource or solution, a platform for channel partner. Actually, the most particular, especially the technology change so fast that with application driven. So customer need, okay, they don't need to buy something, they want to subscribe something. This is like a telco model. So GCR provide all this back end for channel partner to run a kind of a subscription model. So they have a recurring revenue. For example, they signed a 2 years contract with the customer, then they can guarantee the 2 years revenue. So I think this is a very important value to the channel partner, okay, to transform them, not only get the additional IoT solution, but also transform them from the buy and sell and price cutting, okay, to become a real service. But in order to do that, the channel partner want to do the service, they need assistant. So we do have assistant. And so one way we get a lot of solution, the other way we have assistant for them to run in all this kind of recurring revenue. Yeah, so this is the GCR value. Yeah.
Okay. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you.